Mixing in Nuendo is very enjoyable. The VST channel mixer has a well-designed layout that makes it very pleasing to work with. However, there are other ways to enhance your mixing abilities. There's a few tips I'd like to share with you that can provide you with even more options for getting your mix to sound spot on. There are two specific subjects we'll talk about in this tutorial, both of which have already been introduced in previous movie tutorials. First is the automation system. We discussed the automation system within the mixer automation tutorial in the mixing topic. There are a few ways you can use the automation in a special way to help enhance your mixing abilities. Second is the event volume handle, which we discussed in the audio and MIDI event handling tutorial in the editing topic. Using the volume handle on events allows you to make quick and detailed changes to the volume of a specific event within any track. Let's take a look at how this all works. Using automation to mix with gives you an enormous advantage over conventional consoles where you constantly have to keep writing your faders for sweeps, fades, and other dynamic movement you want to happen within the mix. Not using automation can also lead to the inevitable fader wars, where you adjust one track to sound good at one spot in the song, but suddenly alters how it sounds in the rest of the song. This is no longer a problem when you mix with automation. Here's how it works. First, I spend a little time getting a rough mix of how I want the song to sound. Then I'll go through and add markers to places within the song that I feel need the most drastic changes in dynamics, overall levels, frequencies, or simply where something different needs to happen. Next, I'll open up the automation track for this bass line. I'll activate the read automation mode, and I'll insert an automation point right where the marker is. Now what this has done is created a separation point for the automation. It now allows me to make any adjustments I need to this section without affecting the volume or automation of any other sections of the project. Once I get everything the way I want it for this area, I can move on to the next section, create a marker, and now I can alter this section again without disrupting any of the previous work I've already done. If I need to apply effects to just a specific section, then I have two choices. I can either cut out the area I need and place it on its own track and apply real-time insert effects, or I can simply use the offline process to apply just the plugins I need as we covered in the offline processing tutorial in the processing topic. This method of automation mixing helps break up a large project into smaller sections, so you don't have to tackle the entire mix as a whole. After working on each part and getting it right, you'll end up with quite an amazing mix, and without having to run all over the place trying to maintain levels and fades. To take this one step further, you can get even more intricate with your mixing by using the volume handles found on audio events. These allow you to adjust the volume level of any specific segment of a track. This works great since you don't have to worry about altering or fiddling with the main volume fader or having to make edits to your automation track. You simply splice the part you need, grab the handles, and adjust it as necessary. If you know the exact amount you need to boost or cut in decibels, then you can use the info bar at the top to type in the desired level adjustment. The only thing to watch out for when using this method is that the adjustment happens pre-fader. This means that it adjusts the volume of the event before it gets to the mixer channel. This can cause a problem if you're using dynamic-based effects like compressors or limiters that work based on how loud the input level is. By adjusting levels of the events, it can cause the compressors or limiters to work and sound different, since the volume level going into them has changed when we adjusted the event volume handle. In this case, it's better to use the trim automation mode to adjust the automation of the area you need, since the automation actually controls the volume fader. The quickest way to do this is to splice the event area you need. Use the locators to event command to instantly set your locators to this area, and then trim the automation data as you see fit. So, automation and event handles, two great ways to enhance the way you mix. And this is only a sample of the many ways in which you can combine all the automation, event, and mixer capabilities to come up with methods that is best for you and the way you work.